Hi there, it's Dr. Lisa Schwartz, and today we're going to talk about something that I get a lot of questions about, and that is, what tests do I need when I'm diagnosed and after I finish treatment? Well, most patients are diagnosed with early stage breast cancer. The staging studies are really pretty simple. First, you should have a thorough physical exam by your oncologist and routine labs. So routine labs are a complete blood count to assess your white cells and your red cells, and also serum chemistries. The chemistries help us to assess your liver and kidney function, among other things. And that's all the basic labs that you need. Secondly, you should have bilateral mammograms. Most of you had bilateral mammograms as your screening test, and that's how you found the cancer. But some of you found it just by physical exam. And if that's the case, you definitely need bilateral mammograms. Now, if your doc found something else on the mammograms or something on physical exam that needs further evaluation, then you need either an ultrasound or an MRI usually, depending on what he or she found. Now, those studies are not necessary unless something turned up on your physical exam or on the mammogram that needs further evaluation. And lastly, we need to know what your estrogen receptor, progesterone receptor, and HER2 new status is. And those things usually can be determined off the biopsy specimens. So often we know those things before you even go in to have your definitive surgery. But if not, then they're certainly done on the surgical specimen. And those tests really help determine what your care is going to be. So those are really the only things you need for staging. Now, people have asked about the need for CT scans, PET scans, and bone scans, but your risk of having disease outside of the breast with those early stages is just so low that you're kind of just going on a wild goose chase if you get those other studies. Now, if you have some abnormal labs or if you have some other specific symptoms, then your doc may order some of those other tests to help evaluate those symptoms. If you have stage 3 or 4 disease, then your workup is usually more thorough because your risk of having disease outside of the breast is a little bit higher than folks with the early stage disease. So you may find that you're getting some of those extra studies. So that's really it for staging. And follow-up is pretty simple too. The first thing you need is to see your doc 1 to 4 times a year. Usually what I would do is see patients about every 3 to 6 months for the first 2 to 3 years and then spread it out a little bit more after that. Now, usually your oncologist will follow you for about 5 years. And if you're on tamoxifen or an aromatase inhibitor, it might be a little bit longer than that. But you can still be on those medications and be managed by your primary care physician if you're not having any problems with them. And the second thing that you need besides seeing your oncologist is bilateral mammograms every year. You never get away from that. But you don't need them any more frequently than once a year. The good news is if you've had a mastectomy, even with breast reconstruction, you usually don't need any kind of imaging of that area. So for follow-up after treatment, you need physical exams. After the first 5 years, you can go to yearly. And it can be done by your primary care physician, usually after about the first 5 years. Second, you need bilateral mammograms. Now, if you're on tamoxifen and you still have a uterus, meaning you've not had a hysterectomy, then you need to see a gynecologist for a yearly exam. If you're on an aromatase inhibitor, one thing you might want to do is get something called a bone mineral density test that measures how healthy your bones are. Aromatase inhibitors can cause some bone loss, so you need to keep an eye on that. Now, usually you get that test when you're starting the AI, and then your doc will sort of get it periodically. You don't necessarily need it once a year. So that's about it. Yearly mammograms and physical exams really are what you need. Now, I hope this has been helpful for you. If you're interested in more information about breast cancer, nutrition, and healthy lifestyle changes, be sure to visit my website and blog at lisaschwartzmd.com or subscribe to my YouTube channel at lisaschwartzmd. Thanks for your time and attention, and I'll see you next week.